She was very pretty. Spoke with a country club accent. Brain surgeon's daughter, new in town. I told her I would buy the tickets if she would drive. A girl with a country club accent shouldn't see my car. She's at my door in a souped-up orange Mustang, gift from her father. Little late, little frazzled. She stopped along the way to help somebody who was in an accident. Nice of her. She drives like a teenage boy. Sideswipes an SUV. Lights and sirens soon after. The officer calls in, "Yeah, I think I got your hit and run from before." "What?" "Yes, officer, the car's registered in Dr. Matthew Burns' name." "Miss, I'm gonna ask you one more thing. Can you touch your thumb behind your back?" And I know what's coming next. She's handcuffed. This is our first date. What are the demands of chivalry in that situation? I ask the officer if I can approach, if I can use her cell phone to call her family, keep my hands where he can see them. "What's happening?" she asks. I tell her I will not leave her until she's safely home. Chivalry. Another officer arrives on the scene. There are entries in her cell phone for mom and dad, different area codes. I leave them both the same message. I'm a friend of Katie's. She's been arrested for drunk driving. I will call you with any information as soon as I get it. I will not leave her. I ask the officer where she's being taken. "Oh, the station's just up the road. If her record's clean, you can get her out for $40 once a bailiff shows up." "Officer, this is our first date." He laughs. Hard. "Son, go bail your date out of jail. You know what comes next."